back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
A commoner engaged in sex with an Alaje nobleman's wife, a criminal offense. Discovered, he fled, seeking refuge among the Ija people, who granted him asylum. The Alaje demanded his return and death. Now an issue of pride, the Ija refused. This dispute threatened to escalate into warfare. Negotiations were held. The Alaje and Ija formulated a shared moral code, condemning witchcraft, war, and theft. However, the Alaje would not compromise regarding the escaped commoner. Either he had to return to face the death penalty or a substitute had to die for him, and so an enslaved woman was produced to serve as ransom. Before she was executed, she was expected to pray and follow ritual procedures, but this woman, described as devoutly religious, could not. All she could say was, "Ilala," which translates as, "The world is incomprehensible," a cry of protest against the injustice of her fate. Following her death, she was deified and called Ilala. Her real name is a ritual secret. She is a historic person, a deified mortal. Details of her life are secret, revealed only to initiates. Ilala is associated with witch trials. Ordeals to determine whether malicious witchcraft has occurred are held at her shrine. She is an arbiter of social morality and justice. Ilala is petitioned to provide justice and to punish those who have caused harm or broken crucial social codes. She is also invoked for prosperity. Shrine. Her primary shrine is on the small island where she was executed. Public altars are erected near riverbanks, and people maintain home altars as well. Allied spirits. Babaluaye, Eshu Elegbara, Chango. Favored people. Those who fish professionally or who ply the sea for their trade. Sacred sites. Lagoons. Color. White. Bird. Parrot.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.